Randwater sê die pompe by al sy pompstasies werk dag en nag om leerreservoirs weer vol te maak. Maar vooral in hoogliggende gebiede gaan het stadig en die waterdruk is laag. Inwoners staan intussen tou vir water.
Ek kan nie kook nie. Ek is gefrustreerd omdat ons nie water het nie. Omdat ons nie kan bad in die water nie en kan wasgoed was nie en skottelgoed kan was nie, niks.
Ons sal graag wil weet hoe lang gaan dit nog regtig vat. Dat hulle eerlik met ons is, dat ons weet wat moet ons doen, wat se voorbereidings ons moet tref.
Kenners sê dit neem tyd om waterprobleme uit te stryk.
Unlike electricity where it goes off and then you fix the problem and it goes on everywhere again, water once it goes off, it takes a very, very long time to get back. That's why we can't afford to have this kind of interruption. It's just too difficult and disrupting to put supplies back in place.
Munisipaliteite vra inwoners ook om die beskikbare water spaarsam te gebruik, sodat die stelsel weer kan stabiliseer. Miller sê hy is stom geslaan deur Randwater se gebrekkige rugsteunstelsels.
Don't understand how a large organization, it's part of our national heritage. Randwater is older than South Africa. It's been really reliable over, you know, decades. I do not understand how they could allow a situation like this to develop.
'N tekort aan vaardighede dra ook by tot die krisis.
The people in power, the politicians, don't have they don't see the need for having so many people in place. And if you don't have the people in place who can manage the system, as well as do the forward planning, then you're going to run into trouble at some point.
Intussen is watertankwaans in verskeie woonbuurte van Gauteng se 3 metropolitaanse munisipaliteite, Tshwane, Ekurhuleni en Johannesburg ontplooi. Plaaslike ondernemings oral in Gauteng sukkel om sake te doen. Dit lyk of die watertoevoer na Pretoria stadig aan begin regkom, maar probleme duur voort in Midrand en Centurion asook die Wes- en Oosrand.